Greetings and salutations. My name is Lev. I do a comic and animation series called Tales of Mere Existence. I'm going to be showing you three episodes of this tonight. The first one is called Late Stage. The second is Samaritan 2020. And then later in the evening, be showing one called The Time I Went to a Strip Club. That is all. Enjoy. The other day, I was in this store looking around, and I was struck with an overwhelming urge to not buy anything. It wasn't just because everything looked cheap, flimsy, and disposable, but also because I started thinking about all the effort it took to fill a store with tawdry crap that I don't want to buy. Whatever the product, I thought, some market researcher dreamed up this piece of shit, hired someone to design the piece of shit, got a third world factory to manufacture tons of this shit, had a barge sail the shit across the sea onto trucks to haul the shit to stores across the country, all in the hopes that enough consumers would decide that they needed this stupid piece of shit in their lives. Of course, in a few months, all the shit they sold would be unfashionable, broken, or obsolete, so it would wind up in a landfill, just like all the unsold pieces of shit. It all seemed kind of asinine, so I left the store. On my way out, I was thinking of all the recent talk about late-stage capitalism. I haven't made up my mind what I think about this, but I certainly see their point. A couple of days ago, I was walking down Clement Street in San Francisco when this guy pulled over on his bike and asked if I knew where the closest Wells Fargo bank was. For reasons you may have guessed, I stood back a few feet before I began answering him, but then he said, "What? What? I can't hear you. Come closer." I did my best to be polite when I said, "Sure, but could you put on a mask first?" And then I got to see what I have so far only heard about. The guy freaked out, called me paranoid, called me a pussy, and started going on about how I was a sheep for the deep state 5G brain implant vaccine conspiracy socialism. He was still yelling when I gave up and walked away. In a weird kind of way, I'm almost glad that it happened. I've read about this kind of thing on my phone, but I think I needed to experience it to fully accept it. Anyway, I know you're really not supposed to wish misfortune on people even when they're dickheads to you, so I spent the rest of the afternoon trying not to think of this guy encountering an aggressive, overtly hostile rhinoceros. I mostly succeeded. Mostly. I have only been to one of these things once, and it wasn't my idea. I was out having drinks with a friend, and he asked me if I wanted to go to a strip club. At first, I guess I was kind of indecisive about it, but he insisted and said he could charge it all to his company credit card. So I said, "Sure, what the hell, let's go to a strip club." The place we went was neither high class nor a dump. They checked our IDs, and we went in. Now, if you've only seen them in movies and on TV, you may expect strip clubs to be sleazy, exciting, and dangerous, with the men full of wanton lust and the women full of daddy-issue cocaine vulnerability. Maybe this is what I expected, too, but it wasn't what I saw. The dancers were beautiful, but looked utterly bored out of their skulls, and all the men in the place just looked like lonely guys that had nowhere else to go. Me and my friend sat down and watched all of this for a while. I think a lot of the dancers were from Europe or the Eastern Bloc, and it looked like most of them were operating on autopilot for the time being. It was actually kind of boring, and so I started to think about something else when one of the women came up and started jiggling around on my friend. He had gotten himself a lap dance. Then another girl came up to me. He had gotten me one, too. The gal said she was from Sweden, and her rack was so big it was borderline sarcastic. She proceeded to slap them around while saying, "Look at my Swedish meatballs. You like my Swedish meatballs. Bouncy, bouncy Swedish meatballs." I never thought there could be a situation where having enormous tits in my face could be uninspiring, but there it was. I forget how long we stayed because my friend disappeared for a little while. I never asked where he went, but that was pretty much our night. Anyway, on the way out, I saw this guy getting a lap dance from the same girl that had given me one. I remember hoping that he was having a more thrilling and satisfying time than I had had, but it didn't really look like it.
Thank you for attending this week's edition of Club Closed. If you wish to find me and my work again, here is all of my Webernet info. I believe that is all. Have a good rest of the night, and see you next time.
Some experts estimate one out of every three bites of food we eat depends on the work of honeybees. But the future of the insects is now in peril with widespread reports of bee colony collapses. I keep it juicy, juicy. I eat that lunch. Yeah. She keep that booty, booty. She keep that pump. Yeah. That natural beauty, beauty. Yeah, yeah. If you could see it from the front, we tell you see it from the back. Back, 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 juicy. Back, back, yeah. Back, 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 juicy. Back, back, back.
where you at, huh? A lot of niggas wanna know how long it take to pull my pants up. Poke a finger, nail it in something. Tryna squeeze into my true religion, that numb.
Last decade and a half, the nation's beekeepers have reported staggering declines in their bee populations due to pesticides, parasites, and loss of habitat.
Bring that ass overdose, you bring it back, back, back. I'm a big dog trying to eat the kitty cat, cat. I'm a slide in the way it fit, I could tell we match. All about my racks, hella cheese, I don't fuck with rats. Big crib in Hollywood, I don't even act. Come relax, let a nigga tap, hit you on the app. Take a low, with the wipe the pain away. Juicy and it's tighter than a virgin like Madonna say. I love when you give in, I love when you don't. Hit me with the threesome and sometimes you won't. You told me don't fuck with no bitches, you know. You got it, yeah, you got it, baby, bust it on the floor.
I keep it juicy, juicy. I eat that lunch, she keep that booty, booty, she keep that plump, yeah. That natural beauty, beauty, yeah, yeah. If you could see it from the front, wait till you see it from the back, up.
Could die off at faster rates as the earth warms.
He need that, need the rump and need the thighs. He eat that up and in the night. He see that in the duck and in the ride. He keep that, keep it running like it plump. He need that.